Hi friends, welcome to Galen IAS. This is Let's Score 120 Plus in Prelims 2021 series. And here we'll be solving a model question from Indian Polity. And based on that, we will learn some core facts and concepts to help your prelims preparation. And the question for today is, consider the following statements. The Vice President of India can act as a person for maximum period of 6 months only. The nature of advice given by the Central Council of Ministers to the President cannot be anchored by any court. Once a person is impeached, in order to prevent an interregnum, the incumbent person itself continues to hold office until his successor assumes charge. Find out the correct statement. See, we know that we have president, vice president, all those offices, okay. So, once the person is unable to function because of his resignation, impeachment, death or any other conditions, the vice president of India acts as the president of India, but only for a maximum period of 6 months only. Okay, within that 6 months period, we have to elect a new president. So maximum period a vice president can act as a president is 6 months only. That is a correct statement. So statement number one is right here. Okay. The nature of advice given by the Central Council of Ministers to the president cannot be anchored by any court. See, we know that the president of India can act only according with the aid and advice of Council of Ministers headed by the Prime Minister of India. Okay. And that advice cannot be inquired into any court. That is also a correct statement. Okay. By to maintain that secrecy of the relation between the president and the council of ministers, that cannot be inquired by any court of India. Three says that once a person is impeached, in order to prevent interregnum, incumbent person continues to hold office until his successor assumes charge. See, normally the term of office of president is 5 years. Okay. So usually before the end of 5 year term, we elect the another president, the new president of India. But at any case, if we cannot elect the new president, that incumbent person itself continues to hold office till the next successor assumes charge. Why? Because we always need a president of India to have some functions. So if we could not elect a new president before the end of that 5 year term, that person itself continues to hold off the office till the successor assumes charge. In that case, it is possible. Okay, but once a person is impeached, or once a person is resigned, or if death happens, then the vice president assumes the charge. So the impeached president cannot continue to hold office. Once a person impeached, then what happened? The vice president acts as the president of India. So third statement is wrong here. Why? Because it says that once a person is impeached, in order to prevent interregnum, the incumbent person continues to hold office. No, it won't happen. But even before the term of 5 year term, we cannot elect a new president. At that time, the incumbent person continues to hold office till the successor assumes charge. That's the only condition in which the same person can continue to hold office. Fine. The other cases, the vice president acts as the president of India. That's also for a maximum period of 6 months. Fine. So don't get confused. So third statement is wrong here. So which of the statements is correct? Answer is option B, that is 1 and 2 only. Consider the following statements. The electoral college for the election of vice president consists of both elected and nominated members of parliament. The Central Council of Ministers consists of cabinet ministers and deputy ministers only. The 42nd Amendment to the Constitution of India made the ministerial advice binding on the governor, similar to that of president at the center. Find the non-correct statement. Okay, so regarding statement number one, the electoral college, we must know the electoral college of president as well as vice president because they are indirectly elected. Okay, the president is elected by elected MPs as well as elected MLAs of both states as well as union territories having legislature. But regarding the election of vice president, he is elected by both elected and nominated members of parliament only. So this differences please note down. Okay. So electoral college of election of vice president consists of both elected as well as nominated members of parliament. Statement number one is correct. Two says that the Central Council of Ministers consists of cabinet ministers and deputy ministers only. No, the cabinet ministers consist of the Central Council of Ministers consists of cabinet ministers, then minister of state, deputy ministers, as well as parliamentary secretaries. These constitute the Council of Ministers. This depends upon their function. So the cabinet ministers are in charge of some of the important ministries, like say example Ministry of Defense, Foreign Affairs, Home Affairs. So the important ministers from the part of cabinet system. MOS means, that is Minister of States, is next in rank to the cabinet minister. Okay, one more thing, the cabinet ministers have independent charge of a ministry. Okay, an MOS Minister of State may have independent charge or may be under or subordinate to the cabinet minister. Okay, and deputy ministers at any case does not have independent charge of any ministry. They usually assist the cabinet ministers or MOS. Similarly, parliamentary secretaries, they are the last of the cabinet they are last of the council ministers. They usually assist the above ministers. Okay, so used in cabinet meeting, they present. In some cases, Minister of State are also included in the cabinet meeting, provided if they have an independent charge of any ministries. At any case, deputy minister or parliamentary secretaries does not attend the cabinet meeting. So these differences please note down. These differences or this classification is based on the functions performed by those ministers. Okay, so council of ministers consist of cabinet ministers, minister of state, deputy minister, as well as parliamentary secretaries. So statement number 2 is wrong here. 1 is correct, 2 is wrong here. 3, the 42nd amendment to the Constitution of India made the ministerial advice binding on the governor similar to that of person at the center. That is a wrong statement only. See, we know that 42nd Amendment Act made the advice of the Council of Ministers of the center binding on the president. Similar provision is not applicable at the state level. Any act or any provision of the Constitution does not mandate that the Council of Ministers advice is binding on the governor. No such provisions are there under our Constitution. But there is for the president. Once a Council of Ministers gives some advice, it is binding on the president. But if a state council gives some advice to the governor, that is not binding on the governor. That difference you please note down. So 3 is also wrong here. So 1 is correct, 2 is wrong, 3 is wrong. Since we have to find out the not correct answer, our answer becomes option C, that is 2 and 3 only. Okay,